Hello everyone, I'm Richard Flanagan. I'm a psychologist by training, and then I became an internet entrepreneur and started a company focused on helping people learn new skills and get self-help. I then worked with a company developing learning and development programs, and that's really where I got interested in the broader sense of how we can really help people, companies, and organizations change in ways that really improve their lives, their companies, their relationships in meaningful ways. While there, I co-wrote, authored the original Six Disciplines of Breakthrough Learning, How to Turn Training and Development into Business Results. And now I use this book and other tools for behavior change as an executive coach and as offering corporate training and development programs. So what I'm going to do today is walk you through the six disciplines and talk a little bit about how I've used those and how I currently use them, not only in corporate training and development, but in meetings and event planning, and also in my own life. So let me just walk through the six disciplines real quickly. I'm just going to draw them up here on the board. We're going to start over here with D1, which is define business outcomes. And when I say that, people say, well, of course, define business outcomes. Why wouldn't you do that before you start something? That's the first step, but it's the one that frequently gets missed the most. People usually are asked to give a program for leadership or management or sales or something because we need one. But why? And why, here is a critical question for D1, for starting anything. I don't know if any of you have seen Simon Sinek, but Simon Sinek has what he calls, I think, the golden circles. And his book is Start With Why. And why is right in here. Out here is what. And in here is how. In D1, probably the most critical question you can ask is why. Now, if you think about this, people start saying, we need a program in learning and development, or we need a program in management, or that's a what. We need a sales program. That's what we need. And then people go to, well, how are we going to do that? Well, we're going to put together, we're going to hire these programs, and we're going to dump all this information on people. The real question is why? What do you want to get out of it? What are the business results you're actually seeking? Now, if you think about learning and development in general, in many companies, they have learning and development. That's what it is. We have a learning and development department. How they do it, we've got programs, we've got LMSs, we've got all these programs you can take. The real why, though, is getting business outcomes, helping people do things differently and better in ways that deliver meaningful results for the company and for themselves. Now that sounds like a great place to start, and it is, but many people want to rush that. They don't want to spend the time to really get that clear, and also get clear about how they're going to measure it when they're done. So the next D, is D2, is design complete experiences. Oops, I didn't leave enough room there, but I'll just put it down here. Now, fundamentally, if you think about learning programs, they're usually an event. They're not an experience. There may be an experience of that event, but to have it really happen in a way that people can change and do things differently and better, it has to be extended. It has to go beyond the event. There has to be preparation. There has to be a whole series of steps along the way and an extension beyond the end of the program. Now, in my work with Bob Dean, we've added a number of things in here, one of which is the Doblin model of an event. Attracting, entering, engaging, exiting, extending. All those are critical factors in getting a complete experience that will really help people change and do things differently and better. Change doesn't happen just because you say change. D3 is to deliver for application. And what does that mean? If you think about most programs, they're focused on learning. How do you get learning to happen? How do you get information in? The key in any good learning program is to focus on how do you get people to apply what they're learning. You know, people always used to say knowledge is power. No, the application of knowledge is power. And so D3 focuses on what are the things we need to do to get people actually applying the learning in meaningful ways that deliver results. D4 is drive follow-through. Now, everybody knows to get successful at anything, you need to follow through. The question is, are we good at doing that for ourselves? Driving follow-through implies holding people accountable, helping people hold themselves accountable. And that gets combined with D5, which is active support. Deploying active support in D5 is absolutely critical, and it's critical that D4 and D5 be in balance. If you don't have the balance of D4 and D5, you want to have, think of it as a scale. You got D4 over here, accountability, D5 over here is support, and you want all the pieces here to be match up with the pieces here in ways so that the scale is balanced. Otherwise, you're driving people and pushing them too hard and not supporting them, or if you're supporting them and not helping hold them accountable, you're probably not going to get the results you want. So the key here is holding people accountable and really focusing on balancing those two elements to get results. Now, one of the things that Bob Dean and I have been working on a lot is how to use collaboration communities to accomplish that, where people can come together, people that are learning together, and share information and ping off of each other to make things go even further, supporting each other, but also holding each other mutually accountable. Finally, we get to D6, which is document results. And that really means document and measure results. So we've got D1, D2, D3, D4 and 5 in balance, and then D6. And the key to D6 is to get and document and measure results, that needs to be defined right out here in D1. In the very beginning, with your stakeholders, with the people that are taking the program, with whatever you're doing, make sure you understand that in the beginning. The worst thing that can happen is you get to the end of the program and somebody says, well, what were the results? And nobody's ever discussed how to do that. So D6 is documenting results. When you put all this together, you've got a big continuous improvement process, because once you get those results, you go right back to D1 and start thinking about how to make it better. Now, as I said before, I've used this in lots and lots of programs. When people are always asking me, what's the most important D? They always ask me that. And I say, well, the key is optimizing all the D's. But if I had to answer that question, I'd start right here. Because if you don't get this right in the beginning, the why you're doing the program and what are the results you're seeking, you're probably not going to get where you want to go. So that's an overview of the six disciplines. Just to give you an idea, Bob Dean and I have been working a lot on this, combining his work in the experience economy and my work in the six disciplines. We've now got a whole chart here laying out many of the factors in the six disciplines that need to be considered for any program to get really good results. So, I hope you've learned something today, and it's been a pleasure talking to you, and I hope to see you again. Thank you.